The Nixon administration has already shut down the New York Times for trying to publish them. And the Post is in a precarious financial position. So she has to make a hard decision whether to back down or print and risk the paper's future. You will find two characters on this scene. Are you ready? Let's go, people. Vanity, the guy, and Catherine, the woman.
So, can I ask you a hypothetical question?
Oh dear, I don't like hypothetical questions.
Well, I don't think you're gonna like the rerun either.
Do you have the papers?
Not yet.
Oh gosh! Oh gosh! Because you know the position that would put me in. You know we have the language in the prospectus.
I know. Investors can change their minds. I know what is at stake. You know the only couple I knew who both Kennedy and LBG wanted to socialize with was you and your husband, and you own the damn paper. Cause that's the way things worked. Politicians and the press, they trusted each other so they could go to the same dinner parties and drink cocktails and tell jokes while there was a war raging in Vietnam.
I don't know what we're talking about. I'm not protecting Lyndon.
No, but you've got his former Secretary of Defense, Robert McNamara, the man who commissioned this study, with a few dozen party guests out on your patio.
I'm not protecting him either. I'm protecting the paper.
Yeah, well, I was a stooge for Jack Kennedy the night he was assassinated. Tony and I went down to the Naval Hospital so we could meet Jackie when she landed. And she was bringing Jack's body back on the plane from Dallas. And she walked in the room. She was still wearing that pink suit with Jack's blood all over it. She fell into Tony's arms and they held each other for quite a long time. And then Jackie looked at me and said, "None of this, none of what you see, none of what I say is ever going to be in your paper. Paper." And it just about broke my heart. I never thought of Jack as a source. I thought of him as a friend. And that was my mistake. And it was something that Jack knew all along. We can't be both. We have to choose, and that's the point.
The days of smoking cigars together down on Pennsylvania Avenue are over.
Your friend McNamara's study proves that. The way they lied. Those days have to be over. We have to be the check on their power.
If you don't hold them accountable, I mean my God, who will?
Well, I've never smoked a cigar. And I have no problem holding Jack or Lyndon or Bob or any of them accountable. We can't hold them accountable if we don't have a newspaper.
When I get my hands on the study, what are you going to do, Mrs. Graham? Happy birthday, by the way.